Elizabeth Crutcher from Solve in Mount Pleasant, Tennessee. I have three of my colleagues with me today. Joel Anderson, Health Safety Environmental Engineer, Jason Rettinger, the Logistics Supervisor, and we have Will Kester, who is a Production Superintendent. Today we're going to talk to you about recycling. Now, we're almost absolutely 100% sure that you guys know the three R's: reduce, reuse, and recycle. Today we're going to take you a little deeper.
One of the biggest benefits of recycling is conserving our natural resources. We've brought today some examples of some of Earth's natural resources that we want to conserve. Trees, most importantly, rocks, which we process into metals, and oil, which comes from the earth. When we use natural resources, we make products such as copper cups, or lubricants, or batteries, or anything that we can make from natural resources. Natural resources are limited, which means we only have a certain amount until they're gone, and that's why we want to conserve them. In order to reduce the amount of natural resources we consume, we should use items that are reusable instead of throwing them away. A couple more examples of things that you can reuse are metal or copper reusable straws instead of plastic straws, and reusable grocery bags instead of plastic bags that sometimes are thrown away.
All right, so when it comes to recycling, it's important that we know what we can and cannot recycle. Not everything that we have that we throw away can be recycled, such as, you know, food waste, styrofoam. Those type of things can't be recycled. But like those items that Will said that are made from natural resources, those are the ones that we can recycle. So some examples could be, you know, cardboard boxes. You know, everybody loves the Lucky Charms. If you look at these, if you look at your box, typically there'll be a recycle symbol on there. It'll tell you what you can and can't recycle. So this one says you can recycle the paper box, but you cannot recycle the plastic bag that's inside. So it's important that we're looking at those symbols and following their directions, so we're not recycling things that can't properly be handled at the recycling facilities. Some other examples, you know, could be plastic. When it comes to plastic, you have many different types. There's seven different categories of plastics, and not all of those can be handled and recycled effectively. So for example, this one, you see inside the triangle, it's got number two. A number two plastic stands for HDPE, which is a specific type of plastic. Number two plastic can be recycled by most recycling companies. Your plastic water bottles, they're a class one. It's a PETE type plastic. This plastic, commonly used in water bottles, your 20-ounce soda pops, those type of plastics can also be recycled. Moving on to aluminum, you know, aluminum cans, these are all acceptable. So if you have aluminum cans, you can go ahead and throw those into the proper recycling bin. And last but not least, you know, kind of in addition to your cardboard, paper is also a form of material that can be recycled. So if you've got junk mail, scrap paper from your schoolwork, those type of things, instead of throwing them into the trash, you can go ahead and throw it into a recycling bin. All right, so I'm sure most of you guys have seen these type of bags at your local grocery store. These types of bags are recyclable. However, you can't throw them in your recycling bins at home. Most of your local recycling facilities can't handle them. So the best thing to do, and it says it right here on this bag, if you take it back to the store, they're gonna have a drop where you can, you know, bunch these up, put it in the container, and then the stores will take those bags and recycle and reuse them.
Our we have taken each of the items and separated them into two piles, one of them that are recyclable and the ones that are not. Now you may be asking yourself about some of these ones that are over here on the non-recyclable side, why they are not recyclable. For the paper towels and stuff like that, paper products, if they're clean, yes, they are recyclable, but most time they're going to be contaminated with food or other stuff that you've used to clean up a spill or whatnot, so those would not be recyclable. Also with these paper plates and these cups here, they have wax coatings on them that's going to give the recycling companies issues when we try to recycle those. Now of course you got the styrofoam cups. So styrofoam makes up about 35% of the landfill waste that is in the United States, so that is one of the biggest non-recyclables that we can definitely try to reuse other items to be able to reduce that waste. And also for these paper here, it's heavy paper that has got a lot of dye on it, so that would also be non-recyclable for most of the recycling companies. Of course we have, you know, these rings, the plastic rings that you get your soda pops or, you know, other beverages in. You see these a lot in commercials about the sea life and birds and whatnot being wrapped up in these. So, you know, if we have an option to buy, you know, usually you buy them by singles, or we can also use these that, as Joel had mentioned in the previous video, that these are recyclable. So these would be the better option to use.
We hope you enjoyed this presentation. I'm Elizabeth.
I'm Joel.
I'm Jason.
And I'm Will. Thanks for watching our video on recycling. Always remember to reuse, reduce, and recycle so we can save our natural resources.